In this video, I'll show you how to use the Photoshop script AutoCrop. This script uses Photoshop's Select Subject feature to determine the subject, and then uses the selection to calculate how to crop the image. This can save hours of manual work for a large number of images that require consistent cropping. The best way to demonstrate is to simply run the script, first on a single image, then a folder of images, and explain the options as we go. I already have a Photoshop action to run the script. For help setting up scripts in Photoshop, see the link in the description for another video that shows the steps. Let's get started. First, let's see some images to test with. Here in Bridge, I have 4 images. In actual use, we can process many more. That's the idea. But for this demonstration, I want to keep it simple. As you can see, the model position and size vary quite a bit. No, it wasn't the photographer. Annie'd do better than this. I made the test images inconsistent on purpose to help demonstrate the script. To start, let's work on a single image before processing the entire folder. I'll open the first image. Before using this script, I want to point out something important. The script relies on Photoshop's Select Subject feature. If Select Subject has trouble with an image, the script will have the same trouble and won't crop right. So keep that in mind. For this test image, we can see that Select Subject works well. Before we continue, take note of the size and resolution of the image. 2000 by 2500 pixels, set to 300 pixels per inch. We'll see how this value changes depending on the options used. Now to run the script, start by opening the Actions panel. Select the Auto Crop script in the list. Click the Actions panel Play button. The script runs, which displays the interface. The interface has 5 sections: Process, Size, Resolution, Output, which only applies to processing a folder, and Settings, to save and reuse the options currently set. To start, we'll use default settings. 5x7, 1/2 inch margin, and resolution as is. Click OK and processing begins. As you can see, the model is now well centered. Let's have a look at the image size. As expected, the result is 5x7 inches. But notice the pixels per inch have changed. This is a result of the as-is resolution option. No pixels are added or removed other than pixels cropped away. The subject remains the precise pixels it was to begin with. The number of pixels per inch changed to arrive at the size. Let's back up the history and try the script again. Only this time, set the resolution option to resample to original pixels per inch. When done, there is an alert, because to make the original resolution, the script had to upscale the image slightly. Pixels had to be created. This degree of upscaling should be fine. It's not much. But if upscaled too much, image quality could suffer. The alert is to make you aware. Then you can decide if the result is acceptable. Have a look at the image size, and we can see it is 5x7, and the original 300 pixels per inch. Then there is the third resolution option. This is the same as the second option, only you can specify the resolution. I'll enter 200. Whether an alert appears depends on if the image requires upscaling. In this case, there are plenty of pixels, none added, so no problem, no alert. Image size shows the results we wanted. Now for the best part. Do this to an entire folder of images. To use the script on a folder, we don't need any image open. Run the script, and this time, in the Process section, click Folder. a Select Folder dialog appears. Navigate to the folder of the images to crop. Once in the folder, click Open. The path to the folder now appears beside the folder option. When processing a folder, the Output section becomes active. The first option is Format. This is the file format of the results. The choices are JPEG, PNG, PSD, or TIFF. If JPEG, there's also the option to set the quality. Higher values mean better quality. Next is Convert to Profile. Enable if desired, and choose a profile. Then the results are converted to the selected profile. Original File Name Plus lets you add a suffix to the results. As values for width and height are changed, the text here is updated to match. If not the desired suffix, change it to whatever you like. It just has to be characters legal in file names. You can even make it blank, and results will have the same names as the originals. But be sure the output folder is different from the input, or you'll overwrite. Formats other than JPEG, there's the option to flatten the images. JPEG always flattens because the format doesn't support transparency. Last, there is the folder to which results are output. When the input folder is selected, the output folder defaults to a subfolder named Cropped. The folder is created if it doesn't exist. You can click the Folder button and select any other folder. With everything set, now click OK. The script opens each image in the folder, uses Select Subject to calculate how to crop the image, and then saves the result. If all goes well, the user is notified of how many images were processed. If there are any problems, the concerns are logged, and the script alerts the user. I will demonstrate. We'll run the script again, but this time, increase the margin to 2 inches. These test images don't have enough margin to begin with to end up with that much. The script tells us a log is written. You can click the Open Log button to see the problem. These images do not fill the crop area, so the script has used Content-Aware Fill to add the missing image. In Bridge, we can see the result. Image has been added, but don't count on it being perfect. This image, for example, looks a little funky. That's why the script alerts the user. Then you can confirm the result of each image logged and edit them further if needed. If images aren't cropped too tight to begin with, and the margin value isn't too large, this shouldn't be a problem. Let's run the script again, and this time, crop tighter. We'll make the margin 1/8 inch. Click OK. When done, have a look at the results in Bridge. Note the new results have replaced the last results. The script does this by default. Here you can see the tighter crop. Whatever the value for margin, the images are consistent, the purpose of the script. The last area to cover is the Settings section. We'll open the script again. I'll change some values so it's clear they aren't default. In the Settings section, click Save. Give the settings a name, and the current values are preserved. Open the Load dropdown, and saved settings can be restored.